So welcome to the Human Wildlife Coexistence interview series, where we will be joined by members of our conservation programme teams. My name is Hannah Clare and I am a conservation programme coordinator here at ZSL and will be chairing these interviews. So today on our coexistence interview series, we're joined by Harish. Thank you for being a part of these talks. Could you just start off by please introducing yourself and telling us about the project that you are working on?
Thank you, Hannah. My name is Harish Guleria, ZSL Project Manager, India, working for the Transboundary Tiger Recovery in Nanda Wildlife Sanctuary, India. And I joined the Zoological Society of London in January 2018. And my work is based in Nanda Wildlife Sanctuary and adjoining landscape. And the area is contiguous with the Churia Hills in the Nepal to the Shukla Phanta National Park through Bhum Brahmadev Transboundary Corridor. The conservation landscape is an important tiger habitat block in the central part of the Taraiyaak landscape. And a part of tigers, the conservation landscape is also a good habitat for elephants and is part of Shivalik Elephant Reserve, Uttarakhand, India.
So Harish, what is the status of the tiger population in your landscape in India?
Yeah, as per the All India Tiger Estimation 2018 by Government of India, there are total 2967 tigers in the entire country, so more than 50% of the entire world. And in my conservation landscape, is Nandaur landscape, but when we called as a transboundary Taraiyaak landscape, this is India and Nepal, and start from Rajaji Tiger Reserve up to the Valmiki Tiger Reserve. So as per the last estimate, there are 500 plus tigers in the entire Taraiyaak landscape in India and Nepal. And in my conservation landscape, I'm working in Nandaur conservation landscape, and we have approximately 70 tigers as per 2021 estimates in the conservation landscape. And we have records of breeding tigresses, and we have camera trap pictures of cubs from the conservation landscape. And the density is approximately 4 tigers per 100 square kilometer. So the area is a very good tiger habitat in the transboundary conservation landscape.
That's really brilliant. And what would you say causes tigers to come close or come into communities?
So in the Nandaur conservation landscape, the conflict is not very high. And this is a large habitat block, approximately 2,500 square kilometer areas. And so animals sometimes coming into the agriculture areas, and there is cattle killing and cattle injuries by the tigers and leopards. But there is a Government of Uttarakhand compensation policy, and all the local communities are compensating for any cattle kill or cattle injuries in the areas. And because there is a free cattle ranging in the reserve forest area of the conservation landscape, so there is a space overlap for wildlife and the domestic cattle. So all this conflict happens, but conflict is not very high, and we have government compensation policies in place. So conflict is not very high. And for as far as communities, the park authorities had started training for nature guide for the ecotourism, so involving in livelihood activities. And similarly, we, ZSL and the partners, Wildlife Institute of India and Zoological Society of London, are working with aligned agencies. There is Pantang University, one of the famous university, agriculture university. We are working for different capacity building programs for diversified agriculture, for dairy, for apicultures, to increase the farmers' income to support coexisting in the region.
So Harish, as human tiger conflict is not a big issue now, is your program implementing any measures currently to prevent the potential risk of this being an issue in the future?
Yeah, as the tiger number is going to increase in the coming years, so the conflict is going to be increased in the coming years. So one of the key is increased awareness among communities and education institutions in the conservation landscape to aware people about the mitigation measures, how to mitigate that human-tiger conflict, prevent do's and don'ts One is education and awareness, and then another is habitat management. We manage habitats inside the protected areas, inside the conservation landscape. So there is enough fodder available for the ungulates, for the herbivores. So the herbivores are not staying in the agriculture fields, and subsequently tiger moving after the herbivores. So more habitat available for the wild animals inside the protected areas. And the third one is reducing resource dependency on the forest resources, like for fodder and for forward collections, because we have a government schemes for providing liquid petrol gas and connection for the village peoples. And similarly, we have provided support for the communities for capacity building, for growing fodder, and provided seed for fodder species. So the people are not dependent on the forest for fodder, and they are not sending their cattle to the forest. So I think these mix of interventions like habitat management, reducing resource dependency, and increased awareness among communities, and providing livelihood opportunities for the people, so though they are not venturing into the forest. So this will help in long-term coexistence of tiger and humans in long-term in the conservation landscape.
That's really brilliant. Thank you. Harish, is there anything else that you would like to add that we could learn more about how you and the communities you're working with relate to tigers?
Hannah, the local people in the conservation landscape are God-fearing, and tiger is related to goddess Durga of Hindus. And the people, they worship tiger, and they worship Durga, they worship goddess Durga as worship tiger also. So the tiger conservation future is very bright in the conservation landscape, and young generation is keen on nature education and wildlife, and coming forward for the conservations. And we have been regularly conducting education and awareness programs for the communities and for the education institutions. With the increased awareness, many people are coming forward for conservations. So this is a very good signs. And this JSL project has raised the profile of this Nandaur conservation landscape in the international platform. So this is very good, and this is one of the transboundary linkages. It's India and Nepal. It's the one, because we are like brothers, and we have relations of our daughters are married in Nepal, and daughters from Nepal are married in India. And people are coming from Nepal to India for livelihoods. So this is a relations of livelihood, and this is a livelihood issue, and this is also we have relations in both countries. So I think this is a very bright future for tiger conservation in the transboundary landscape.
That's really wonderful.